Has your VR30 blown up? Now, there are a few reasons why an engine can go. Could have been from things like pushing the engine too hard, coolant mixed with your oil, but chances are your VR30 has blown from oil starvation. Oil starvation can happen because your OEM turbo piston rings are toast, aka your turbo seals. This causes excess burning of oil. I'm sure some can relate to this story. You pull up to a stoplight with your VR30 equipped car and it's smoking up tailpipes. You start to drive and it looks like you're just rolling coal down the street and a Mustang pulls up mocking you.
Cash your Instagram name, cause that shit for the get gap.
Okay.
You're embarrassed, but you want to show that Mustang that your car's a sleeper and you can probably take it. You both downshift and at the third honk, y'all take off. You take the car up to fifth gear and you warn by a fender. As you start to slow down, you hear that dreaded tick, 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 tick. Yeah, well, you just run a bit because you pushed the car when you were low on oil. I tell you this story because in a future video, I will touch on it a little more. So while yes, you can theoretically continue driving with smoking turbos, you're gonna always have to be monitoring your oil level. Another reason for oil starvation is caused by debris in your engine oil solenoid. Thanks to previous CAFE regulations, the VR30 has this solenoid to regulate the oil pressure throughout the rev range. This aids in supplying the engine just enough oil for the low RPM load so the manufacturer can then gain that extra 1 or 2% of mile per gallon that they strive for. So the same reason why the VR30 uses 0W20 instead of 5W30, 0W40, or 5W40 like you should be. By the way, that's probably another reason why your engine blew. 0W20 shears so easily once tuned, and once you throw E in the mix, it's a done deal. Back to the engine oil solenoid, your oil after some miles can get dirty with carbon soot. This soot or other forms of debris can somehow pass the filter and get lodged into your solenoid, causing it to get stuck open. This solenoid stuck open will cause your engine to never go into its high pressure mode. This engine oil pump doesn't produce more than 53 or 54 PSI at full tilt, which is already not enough in my opinion. If you take the car into the upper RPM range when in low pressure mode, chances are your bearings will be shot. You may get lucky and catch it, but most of the times it's too late. If you get lucky, maybe they've been marred, you've already prematurely caused a future failure, or they could have just been hurt instantly to the point where you've been greeted by a low oil pressure light. I've already replaced the solenoid on my Z when I swapped out the journal bearings for the ball bearing turbos that I have currently on the car. The thought of having to buy the solenoid every once in a while as an additional maintenance item just adds up to my already highly maintained car. So what's the fix? Well, I'd like to present to you the new engine oil control solenoid block off. You can now delete your solenoid from any VR30. This is a Jap product that likely will be ready for purchase by the time this video is out. All you have to do is remove the 110 millimeter bolt holding the solenoid and replace it with the block off and you're done.
Look at all that debris. Look at that. Some of that stuff goes past that filter and it ends up getting this thing stuck open. That's not good.
Now I will say getting to this solenoid with the engine in the car, it's gonna take some finesse, but if you're already doing turbos and you're dropping the engine for some reason, this is an absolute must. Get rid of that one item that may cause an engine failure. Don't take my word for it. Go ahead and read on Mark's write-up from Sonic Tunes, or go read up on Racebox's write-up, up to you. But in my opinion, you should replace it, and this Z is definitely getting that replaced. Now, as a token of my appreciation for sticking all the way to the end, I'm gonna give you guys a chance to win one of these block-offs. And I wanna give it away to one of my lucky subscribers. So, in order to win this, all you have to do is obviously be a subscriber. If you're still not a subscriber of my channel, I have no idea what you're doing. You need to like the video, leave a fire emoji in the comment section alongside your Instagram handle or email, and I will be selecting one of you lucky subscribers. So good luck.